Greetings, fellow gorehounds, and welcome back to a Blood Splatter vlog. I'm the Horror Guru, and today we're going to talk about a movie called Slacks, with, two X's. Now, for those of you who don't know, Slacks is a Canadian horror comedy about a possessed pair of jeans that terrorizes a retail store. Now, if you hear that concept and think that this movie is probably going to be some schlocky, stupid horror movie that some hack put together in order to make a quick buck, something like, say, Chopping Mall, for example, you would actually be a little off, because while Slacks does have the perfect recipe for a dumb, schlocky horror film, it is actually way smarter than you would expect. Because in reality, Slacks is actually a satire that comments on and parodies phony corporate wokeness. It's a movie that makes fun of the situation where you have a corporation that has adopted progressive and politically correct language, but isn't using that language to progress the world further in order to make a more equal society, but in order to A, make a quick buck, via using that language as a marketing scheme in order to make people feel good about buying their products, and to B, hide all the exploitation that's happening behind the scenes. And we're not just talking about the way the retail workers themselves are exploited, we're also talking about the sweatshops and the child labor that's happening overseas.
Out of sight, out of mind, as they say.
And this movie just happens to satirize all that while also being an extremely gory and incredibly fun horror film. And when I say gory, my fellow gorehounds, I mean this movie is filled to the brim with a ton of really awesome and gnarly practical effects. Remember that possessed pair of jeans that I referenced earlier? Well, that thing actually does move around in this movie and has a personality unto itself, for reasons I'll get to when we get to the spoilers, and just straight up rips people apart and eats them and strangles them, and it's fucking awesome. This movie simultaneously satisfied the inner gorehound in me while also stimulating my brain region, so it's kind of the whole package. Now, as for the film's downsides, there's only a couple minor ones, and they really manifest in, like, the moments in which you just kind of have to roll with what's going on, even though it doesn't quite make total sense. A great example of that being one scene in which the main character, Libby, is drawn towards a camera because the camera is playing back some footage, and so she hears it, and so she goes over, picks it up, and watches the footage, which reveals to her that there are killer pants on the loose. And while at first glance there's nothing wrong with her getting the information that way, picking up the camera, playing it, and then seeing the killer pants doing its killer pants thing, but where that doesn't entirely make sense is the last time we saw that camera, it was on the ground recording the footage that she walks in and plays. And even if the camera had recorded so long that it filled up its hard drive, it makes no sense that it would switch over to play mode and start playing that footage back when she walks into the room on its own. That's not really how camcorders work. And there's a couple small moments like that over the course of the film that you just kind of have to roll with, and really, I don't think they're gonna bug most people because, honestly, who the fuck cares how cameras actually work? It's not like this is a found footage film or anything. But it is an example of one of the small things I noticed that could have been improved. And my only other criticism is that towards the second half of the film, there's a bunch of kills that happen off screen. And while we do get to see the gory aftermath of those kills, it would have been really cool to actually see them in frame. But I also recognize that was most likely a budgetary limitation and they were doing what they could. But yeah, if you're looking for a movie that satirizes corporate wokeness while being extremely gory, while also demonstrating what a fucking hellscape working retail is, and did I mention also has a subplot that satirizes influencer culture? Then you should definitely check out Slacks with a two X's. Because it's fun, it's smart, it's gnarly, it's socially relevant, and on top of that, this film's even got a Bollywood dance sequence. I can't make this shit up. And speaking of progressive wokeness, if you're the kind of person that likes to support women in film, then you should absolutely check this film out because it was also directed by a woman. Plus, this film's about a killer pair of jeans and its tagline is an ass to die for. Just bah, perfect. Anyway, my fellow gorehounds, Slacks is currently a Shudder original movie, so if you want to check it out for yourself, you're going to have to check it out on that particular platform. And to be clear, I'm not personally sponsored by Shudder, but I absolutely recommend their platform because it's filled to the brim with awesome horror movies, both new and old. as well as films like this one that are original to it. So if you don't have Shudder yet, go check it out and give it a chance. But if you do have Shudder, go check out Slacks and then let me know in the comments below what you thought of Slacks. Was it good, was it bad, or did you feel ambivalent? Let me know below. And with that all said, my fellow gorehounds, let us finally move on to the spoilers. Alright, so this movie follows a character named Libby who has been recently hired to work at this retail clothing store. And one thing that becomes very clear really early on is that this particular clothing store's brand is that it is the woke clothing store. It is the gender-inclusive, racial-inclusive clothing store that is not built upon slave labor, except it kinda is, because as we see in the prologue of the movie, there is child labor being used to pick the cotton that makes these jeans in India. And also, despite all the inclusive rhetoric, it's very obvious that the retail workers at this store are weirdly racially segregated. Like, there's this one section of the store where there's an Asian model photographed wearing some of the clothes of the store and hung on the wall. And on the opposite side of the store, there's a similar photograph but with a black model. And on the surface, it's like, okay, racially inclusive clothing models, I'm down for it. Until I realized the way the work within the store was being delineated by the higher-ups. Because you see, the person working the section with the Asian photograph was themselves an Asian person. And the same dynamic proved to be true with the person managing the section with the other photograph. Which again, on the surface, okay, you have a racially diverse workforce, that's great. Except you took that diverse workforce and delineated their work along racial lines, which is pretty fucking racist. And this movie is filled with a ton of commentary like that. Nice, shiny corporate surface, but if you just scratch a little bit, you'll find a dark underbelly lurking underneath. So anyway, it turns out the parent company that owns this particular store is on the verge of releasing this brand new pair of jeans that is basically one size fits all, it stretches to fit your curves. And in order to promote the release of these new pair of jeans, they have invited a very popular online influencer to come into the store the night before they're released and record a video of her buying and trying them on day one. And the night this is happening happens to be Libby's first night on the job. A night which goes terribly wrong when one of her co-workers decides to steal one of the pair of jeans and try them on herself, only for the jeans to eat her alive and like leave her a complete mangled mess and hide her underneath a sink. And unfortunately, Libby is the one who uncovers the body. But when she goes to her manager and tries to show the manager the dead body, the manager concludes, obviously that girl killed herself and we can't let her killing herself selfishly ruin our big night. So he gets Libby to hide the body in one of the trash bins. Now at first when this part happened, I wasn't sure how on board with it I was, because there was no way you could look at that mangled body and go,
clearly this was suicide.
So at first, this was one of those scenes I just kinda had to roll with and let slide. But as the movie went on, things started to become a lot clearer for me and I realized that actually, I really fucking like this scene. This scene actually speaks to one of the main reoccurring themes of the movie, and that's this. It's corporations treating their workers as disposable. And on a character level, this scene also demonstrates how the manager specifically has internalized and accepted that type of exploitation. And because he has accepted that this is the way it is, he knows that's the way he too must climb the corporate ladder, so he also treats his workers as disposable. And in a great example of the kind of satire this movie has, he has taken that acceptance of the exploitation to such an extreme that he is willing to dismiss an obvious murder as suicide so that it won't ruin the big night in which he might get a promotion. And the moment that really seals the deal in me really loving this scene is the visual metaphor when we see the body in the trash can and then we pull back and we reveal the other trash cans, and in the other trash cans are disposable mannequin parts. Basically saying that this manager, much like the corporation as a whole, has decided that its workers are no different than fucking mannequins. They can just be replaced. And that, my fellow gorehounds, is how I went from looking at a scene and thinking it was dumb and kind of poorly written, to eventually realizing that it was actually low-key genius. and also really funny, but to be fair, I thought it was funny even when I thought it was dumb. So after hiding the coworker's body, Libby's night just goes downhill from there. To the point where the manager can no longer deny that something screwy is going on, so he knocks out Libby so she won't tell people, and the night can keep going forward. Which of course leads to the influencer arriving and trying to film her video with the new pants, but the pants strangle her to death on camera, and then proceeds to go on a rampage, killing everyone in the front of the store. And we got that blood flowing, and it's just so good. And as more and more bodies pile up, we learn a little bit more about how the pants operate. Because it turns out they don't just eat people, they also have the power to subconsciously hypnotize them. And when it hypnotizes them, it basically does that to get them to put the pants on. Which is a very obvious metaphor for corporate marketing. Because just think about it for a quick second. You have these pants that subconsciously convince people that they want, nay, they need to put them on. And the only reason these pants are convincing people to do that is so they can suck them dry. Just replace blood with money and hey, now you have a corporate marketing campaign. So you can definitely see that when I say this movie is a satire, I really mean this movie's a satire. But we're not done yet, folks, as I'm about to spoil the very end twist of the movie. So if you do not want that spoiled, then you should stop right here, pause, go watch the movie, come back, and then finish this vlog from this point forward. Okay, so later on in the movie, there's a point in which the killer pants are stalking an oblivious worker. And not only is this worker of Indian descent themselves, they're also listening to Bollywood music extremely loudly through their headphones. And when the pants hears this music, it gets visibly happy and starts dancing to the music. And after seeing this, Libby gets the idea of getting the coworker of Indian descent to speak to the pants in Hindi, where they discover that the pants are actually being possessed by a dead exploited child worker. And this is also the point where they realize the brand of the company they're working for is complete bullshit. They're not progressive in the slightest, and they've been exploiting child labor for a long time. And if that twist doesn't sum up what this movie is ultimately trying to say, then I don't know what does. Anyway, there's a whole lot more that ends up happening in this movie. There's a point in which the pants actually spreads to more pants, and so you have a whole pants army just eating people left and right. And while I could talk about all that, I really do feel like I've said everything I need to say at this point. So yeah, go check out Slacks for yourself. I can't recommend it enough. Trust me, you're gonna have a lot of fun. And as per usual, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and don't forget to ring the notification bell so that you're notified of my videos immediately upon their upload. And also check out my Patreon page. And remember, if you decide to go the Patreon route, even a dollar a month can go a long way. And with that said, my fellow gorehounds, peace out, and I'll catch y'all later.